It is so cold out here, I just have to start. Now, the Welcome to Christ Clarity Reassurance, the title says Reassurance. And I need to refocus on reassurance because that's really my role, the way I see my role here in this world, is one of reassurance. So I need to, again, tighten the focus on that. What kind of reassurance can I give everyone? Well, the most important reassurance is that there are those who have to go ahead on the path, as it were, come back and reassure everyone, yeah, it's worth going along all the way. You can go around the bend. You don't need to stop and set up shop somewhere along the road. You can go all the way till the end. And it's actually essential to go all the way to the end. In my case right now, I feel very positive, very, very promising, actually. I wouldn't be the slightest bit surprised if I reach the end point, so to speak. And then you go back and you say to those who are going along the road, saying, "Hey, don't stop. Keep going. You can do it. It's worth it. Put in the extra effort. It's worth it. Put in the extra years. It's worth it. But it's worth it. Don't sell yourself short and say, well, I'm just going to, again, set up a shop, set up a business, and all this stuff here based on how far I've gone so far. Now, that's wasting your time. And it's already I see these things happening. It's amazing. If you look at history and you look at the present time, history simply repeats itself continuously. That teachings are given out, and there are those who want to profit on the teachings. And so they try to learn as much as possible real fast, and then they set up shop and start profiting and set up a business and set up a religion and trademark things, copyright things, say that the only way is to do it the way that they have trademarked, etc. What they also say is they lower the bar down and say, this is as high as you can go. Where they're at is the highest you can go. Nobody can go beyond that. So anybody who tries to go beyond that, that is interfering with their business. And then that's when the problems happen. Because someone might be charging $100 for something. Another one comes and says, I'm giving it for free. And the one who's charging $100 says, you can't do that. You can't give it away for free. And so there's all these rules and dogma and all this stuff. It happens perpetually in this world, perpetually. And it's very disappointing, but you shouldn't be so naive to think it doesn't happen this way, because it does. So really the only salvation is to go all the way to the end. And what I'm seeing as I get close to what I see as the end, really, some pretty amazing stuff. Very powerful stuff. Wow. It's worth it. Traveling to the end. Do not sell yourself short. What I've seen in the world is most of us are cowed by those who have turned religion into a business and truth and therapy into a business, and are protecting their business models by saying that you must stop here. And so we think, well, I need to just kind of get up to here, and then that's as far as I can go, and so I'll try to make the best of that. That's not the way to do it. Jesus said, he who persevereth to the end shall be saved. To the end. Okay. You have to persevere to the end. And so you need benchmark. You need those who have persevered to the end to tell you, hey, you haven't done it. You haven't done it yet. That's all important. That's one of the most loving, compassionate service you can possibly do to others. Just tell them, you don't stop. You haven't got it yet. Don't set up shop. You haven't got it yet. Persevere to the end. That's all important. That's the kind of reassurance that's needed. It really is needed here. Because what I see is just so much is going on that is really substandard. They're not persevering to the end at all. Not at all. And they're substituting feel-goodness for failure to persevere to the end. Persevering to the end was going to bring something that is truly profound. Truly profound. And that will reassure many that, hey, this the real fortune is by persevering. That's where the real fortune is. So forget about wasting time on anything else. you, you have to penetrate to the very essence, the very depths of it, to get it, the very depths of it. And anything less than that is coming up way, way short. It's a serious bit. It's a serious situation. The necessity to push through that layer of commercialism that crops up around all teachings in this world. I remember when I was young, I was trying to say something that Jesus said and trying to pass off some wisdom to someone. And they told me, you can't talk about Jesus. You can't use the name of Jesus. I said, why? I said, we own Jesus. We own him. He's ours. You can't talk about him. And they were dead serious, and they're willing to kill me over it. That's how, because that's their moneymaker. That's their power in the world. That's their authority. That's their status. That's their business. They felt they had trademarked and copyrighted Jesus. And so they didn't want me saying anything on my own, just freely dispensing it, and they didn't want people to realize, hey, there's some higher teaching to be gotten, and this other stuff is just mediocre kindergarten kind of stuff. You can't stop at kindergarten stuff. So I have persevered, I have continued on, and what I'm seeing now is very promising, but I don't know how things will go. I'm just assuming that promise will be fulfilled. I assume that. I don't know for sure, though. But I know those insights are there to be gotten. I know that they're there to be gotten. And so you just cannot give up, and you don't get suckered into anything less than what you truly deserve. And you truly deserve to be able to affirm the truth. Now, A Course in Miracles is really a brilliant motivation towards affirming the truth. The way that Jesus tells us is not to overcome lies, simply to affirm the truth. That is actually the way. That is the way. When you discover that, wow, then you have it. Then you really have it. Then you realize, wow, I've got it. This is what he was really talking about. You don't make illusions real and then overcome them. You simply affirm the truth. And then there's no place for illusions at all. And so I'm getting that. I'm getting it. I see it. I'm using it. And Jesus said the last step you take on this path is to realize that truth is true right now. And today I realized that. I said, wow, truth is true right now. And there's no gap. I understood what he's talking about. There is no gap. The body doesn't create any gap. Truth is true right now. And there's no need to overcome anything. I realized today also, spirit doesn't need to overcome anything. And by affirming that, that is how you return to sanity. Is to affirm sanity. The way is to affirm it. Tell yourself, hey, I'm spirit, and there's nothing that spirit needs to overcome. There's never been anything that spirit needs to overcome. Spirit doesn't need to overcome anything. There's absolutely no necessity in time and space for spirit to overcome anything. That is true. What we don't realize is that the troubles that we have are there because we want to overcome them. See, we have cause and effect reversed in our thinking or belief. We think that the problems come first, and then there's necessity to overcome them. That's actually backwards. Our desire to overcome something comes first, and then what we want to overcome is imagined by us, arrives for us. But by stating we don't need to overcome anything, then no troubles, nothing that needs to be overcome, is attracted to you. That's really the secret. And yet it is quite difficult to accept this. But what's happened in my case is I've suddenly made a turnaround and been able to, I feel I've accepted this in my heart and in my being. I'm saying, hey, this is correct, this is right, and I don't feel any resistance to it. Where before, I said, I couldn't accept it. I could say it, but I didn't really accept it. Now it's sunk me in. I'm starting to say, hey, yeah, this is true. This is true. I don't need to overcome any sickness. I don't need to overcome death. I don't need to overcome impermanence. I don't need to overcome scarcity. I don't need to overcome sadness. I don't need to overcome unhappiness or sadness, same thing. I don't need to overcome any troubles at all. I don't need to overcome any financial troubles. I don't need to overcome tiredness, fatigue. I don't need to overcome anything. How could I? I'm spirit. I'm still as God created me. God did not create spirit needing to overcome anything. Reality doesn't, there's nothing in reality needs to be overcome. We are reality. Spirit is this creation of reality. So there's nothing we need to overcome. That stating that and believing it, knowing it's true, is incredibly powerful. And you can be specific about it. This substance doesn't need to be overcome. This sickness, this illness doesn't need to be overcome. That is the way he heals. It's opposite of the way the world thinks. Opposite. And you're not healing. You're not overcoming anything. You're not healing. You're not curing. You're not overcoming anything. That's true therapy. True therapy is to realize there's nothing that needs to be overcome. No problem to be overcome. And you just have to reassure the one who thinks there is a problem to overcome that there really isn't any problem to overcome. Because spirit doesn't need, there's zero necessity for spirit to overcome any problems. Spirit is just imagining it needs to overcome this because it wants to be prime creator, which is a complete impossible problem. And it would need to change reality to become prime creator, which would necessitate the complete annihilation of reality. And then spirit's trying to figure out, how do I survive the annihilation of reality? And it has all these problems. It says, let me have these problems. Let me learn to work on problems. See, spirit is trying to learn to work on problems to get really good at solving problems, so then it can solve the problem of how to survive the annihilation of reality. There's no necessity of that. Reality can never be changed, will never be annihilated. Zero necessity for spirit to try to work on problems. None. So just affirms. Spirit says, just say, there's no necessity for spirit to overcome anything. No necessity for spirit to overcome anything. No necessity to be an overcomer. None, 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 and none. Zero necessity to overcome anything whatsoever. And so when somebody's sick, ill, the real therapist will just sit there and just affirm that there is no necessity to overcome this illness. None. What happens is not that the illness gains some upper hand or something, is the illness, whoo, flees away. He says, wow, they don't want me here as a problem. I'm not needed here as a problem. So I'll vanish. Because it's an effect, as it were. It's on the level of effect. And the cause is saying, I need a problem to overcome. So give me all these problems and overcome them. That's literally what we're doing to ourselves. We're feeding ourselves problems. And we don't need to. We don't need to at all. And Jesus is just telling us that it's absolute truth what he's speaking. Yet it can be quite difficult to really grasp that, to really see it. It's very difficult for me. It's taken so long. That's what Christian Science was getting to. Mary Baker Eddy and Christian Science was affirmations of there is no sickness. There is no sickness. There's no person needs to overcome any sickness. There's no need to overcome anything at all. And that was really actually very much on track. Very advanced. Christian Science in its pure application, it was a super advanced teaching, really. And of course, Miracles backs that up and makes it even more clear. It gives the fuller context of why that's true. So you don't heal by siding with the illness, saying, yeah, you're sick, but I can make you well. Absolutely not. You say, there's no need to overcome this sickness. There's absolutely no need for that sickness to be there and to be cured of it. None. We don't need to cure anything. Spirit doesn't need to cure anything. How could spirit be sick? What could there be for spirit to cure? That's ludicrous. So we return to sanity. We don't have to cure anything. We just have to return to sanity and recognize there's nothing we need to cure. There's no necessity to overcome any problems or cure anything or heal anything whatsoever. None. Zero. This is the truth. This is the high truth. This is the real truth. This is what you can get to. You can get to this. Because I'm reassuring you, I've gotten to this. I'm seeing it. The fullness of it hasn't blossomed yet. But it's kind of like the bloom is there. The bloom is formed. It just hasn't opened up yet. But when you see a flower, the flower bud is there. And the flower bud is now big. And you can tell it's starting to open. And you know that, boom, a flower is going to come out. I don't know what the flower is going to look like. I really don't. That's interesting to find out. I don't know how I'm going to bloom. What color will the flower be? What shape? All the, you know, in other words, the fragrance. Well, what's the fragrance of the flower going to be? I don't know. I really don't know. But it's something to look forward to. Absolutely, is something to look forward to, which is very reassuring for all of you. Because that's going to be interesting for everybody. It really will. It's a very interesting situation when one aspect of spirit shares with all aspects of spirit that there's zero necessity to overcome anything. How does that play? You know, what is that, how's that like? So anyway, I'm looking forward to that. Really looking forward to it. It's not that you cure anything. You just say there's nothing to be cured. Nothing. Radiate that reassurance. And people catch that. They say, hey, wait a minute. I don't need to cure this such and such. So there's no need to engage with it at all. And then what happens? Pfft, gone. Gone. Gone, gone, gone. Because there's no necessity to overcome it. See, we're a world of overcomers and achievers and learners. That's all the ego. That's all the ego tripping. That's all the delusion of wanting to be prime creator. It comes from that desire. All of it. We don't have to solve any problems. We don't have to overcome anything. And we think, oh, the world will be terrible then. No, it won't. Because all problems will flee. There will be no more problems. We will find, if we took that attitude, we would find ourselves in a flawless, perfect world. And we would not suffer in the slightest bit. There'd be no such thing as suffering or sickness or problems or anything like that. Because we're not calling them to, we're not asking to overcome anything. That's literally what would happen. But how that would happen, we don't need to worry about, because that we're far, far, far from everybody being that way. That is for sure. It's a rarity. It's a rarity if anyone actually employs this, season actually employs it. That's a rarity. It's pretty amazing that in Christian Science there were a lot of people along those lines where I really feel that they were more advanced than we are at this point in a lot of ways. There were some people back in the day, amazing, really. I'm aware of at least one that was seemed to be so incredibly enlightened, it was just unbelievable. And nobody even knows about her, Marie Watts. And she saw the perfect world. She saw perfection everywhere. It's just like, wow. There are a lot of people back in the New Thought Christian Science era who were very advanced, actually, in a lot of ways. Nowadays, not really, not really. That's Kali Yuga. We're at the bottom. We're bottoming out. So you can expect that it's going to be a little bit ragged. So the thing is, for me, is that this Kali Yuga bottoming out is to succeed in recognizing I don't need to overcome anything. There's nothing that needs to be overcome. The Kali Yuga doesn't have to be overcome. There's nothing that needs to be overcome. And therefore, you can simply abide in perfect bliss. You don't have to apply the bliss to anything. There's no reason for the bliss to overcome something. It's just abide in it. And it is possible even now to do that, which would certainly be helpful, reassuring, because once we see that, we say, what's the use of the Kali Yuga and all these cycles? Poof, useless. Let's drop all cycles. Let's drop time. Forget it. We don't need to overcome anything. We spent all this time getting the Kali Yuga. Now we find out we don't even need to overcome that. We thought all this effort to get there, so we could overcome it. And now we find out we don't need to overcome anything. So forget it. Let's just abide in bliss. So The main thing is to do it, because what people are waiting for is to seeing if it's possible. That's what people want to know right now. So talking about it, people waiting say, okay, maybe, I don't know. I'm waiting for, where's the beef? Where's the actualization? Where's the real happening? Let's see it. And then so in seeing it, we'll see how it plays out. But it has to be actually accepted. And I believe it will. In my case, inevitably it will at some point, but hopefully it's at a useful point. The whole thing has to be useful. I don't want to have it draw out and to a point where it's not really, really useful. It's too late or something. It needs to be useful. It needs to be useful for the world, for the all aspects of the sonship, the oneness of spirit, all aspects of the oneness of spirit need to have that share with them, that they need not overcome anything. They don't need to accomplish or overcome anything. Nothing needs to be overcome. Death doesn't need to be overcome. Even you can, that is true, and then death will recede from you, because there's no need. You're not calling to it. Say, hey, death, I need to overcome you. So come here. You're not doing that anymore. Sickness, come here. No. Don't need to overcome any sickness. Don't need to overcome any death. Don't need to overcome any tragedy, any difficulty, any scarcity, any trouble whatsoever, any kind. No necessity, zero necessity to overcome any of it. And then watch that. Watch it flee from you, and watch your life get lit up. So watch the fragrance. Watch the fragrance spread. And from that, hopefully people get a jolt and a big boost and say, hey, let's not set up camp down the road here. Let's put our backpacks on and let's keep on trekking here. Come on, let's not come up short. This is something. We're feeling it now. We're feeling it. We don't need to overcome anything. And we can get that realization. We don't need to overcome anything. I like to employ that with this cold weather. I don't need to overcome the cold weather. No need to overcome the cold. That too. Carry about a microclimate with yourself. It's just everything is perfect. No need to overcome anything. So this is the opposite of the thinking of the world, and where everybody's setting up shops saying, hey, we can help you overcome your problems. We can help you overcome your problems. We got advanced techniques to help you overcome your problems. No, that just makes the problems worse. That just makes the whole situation worse. Spirit thinking, believing that there's something it needs to overcome, and that makes a continuity problem worse. How can spirit remember what it really is if it thinks it has some problem to overcome? It cannot. So anyway, before I freeze, I'm going to cut this short. And we'll see you again soon. Very great. That's it.